find microplastics all over the place. They've been found in soils and waters in all seven continents. They end up in the environment because of they're in a lot of the products that we use. There's small plastic particles in some personal face creams that people use and certain beauty products. There's plastics in clothes that we wear that gets rubbed off and can end up in the environment. And then there's huge, large pieces of plastic that once they get out in the environment, they degrade and they break down into small pieces of plastic. And so a number of people have shown that microplastics are consumed by aquatic organisms. So they look at the stomachs of fish or look at what invertebrates have ingested, and they find that they're being consumed. And what we're really interested in is, does that matter? Does that have an effect on the performance of those aquatic organisms? Does it affect how well they can feed on natural prey? Does it affect how well they grow? Does it affect how well they survive? Does it affect how well they reproduce? And so we tried to assess that not by doing a single study, but rather by pulling together a bunch of different studies that have looked at that in the past. So we found that on average there were effects of organisms being exposed to microplastics on how well they consume natural prey, how well they grow, how well they survive, and how well they reproduce. However, it was highly variable. One thing that's particularly concerning is that some of the organisms that seemed to show the most consistent and strongest effects of being exposed to microplastics were small organisms like larval fish or zooplankton, and that may be of concern because other organisms rely on those small organisms for prey. So if you have strong effect on those very small organisms, that may ultimately translate to having an effect on the upper trophic level organisms that rely on those small organisms as prey. So with Sea Grant, we're interested in informing the public about how they may behave in an environmentally conscious manner. And so we have programs to inform people how they may limit the spread of microplastics into the environment, how they may think about what they purchase, the type of clothes that they purchase, how they dispose of products that they use so that we can limit the amount of large pieces of plastic, but also microplastics that get into the environment.